Hey, Frankie, we're going to test out a battery today? Hey, the old Jackery? What do you think? What do you think, Frankie? Did you get your seatbelt on? Did you get tangled up in the seatbelt? That's special. Good job, Frankie. Safety first. What do you think, Frank? You ready to get the show on the road? Check out the Jackery? Sit. Can you sit?
Guys, you guys know that the Jackery Explorer 3000 pack can power pretty much everything at your off-grid cabin, but did you know it got a lot more uses than that? Just imagine if you were to, you know, use this thing on your everyday adventure. Maybe, you know, you're a construction guy and you need some off-grid power and you want to run some of your hydrating devices. Today I'm going to take this Jackery and I'm going to take it on a little bit of a tour and see what I use it for on a daily basis. Well, let's run through some of the features on this Jackery Explorer 3000 pack. We start off here with all the USB ports. They have USB-A through USB-C, which is the fast charging port that you can use on your iPad or iPhone. There's a DC legacy port, I like to call them. There are the cigarette lighter adapter. That guy there is a DC 12 volt 10 amp, so you can power a lot of DC power. There over here is a pure sine inverter, which allows you to power up to 3000 watts worth of devices. We've already tried this in our last video and we were able to actually power a significant amount more. I don't know if that's highly recommended or not, but it certainly does it. There's four outlets there. There's also a 30 amp RV port at 120, which allows you to plug in your RV directly to this thing. This thing has 3,024 watt hours of juice. And what that allows you to do is, if you guys aren't familiar with DC power packs, that's the capacity that the power pack allows you to use. If you think about it, it's the, you know, how many cookies you got in the cookie jar. This thing has a lot of cookies in the cookie jar. It can power a lot of things for a really long time. Over here, there is the ways to charge it. At the back here, we have a number of ways to charge it. One, you can plug it directly into your household power, which is the AC wattage. It'll charge in about 2.5 hours. You can also charge it through solar. You can also plug it into your vehicle through your DC outlet and charge it that way. And the really cool thing about the Jackery pack, this one specifically, is that it can go down its operating temperature down to minus 20, which is crazy. A lot of other battery packs don't like the cold. This one doesn't mind the cold. To give you an example of the capacity of this pack, say you need 60 watts worth of power, like a traditional CPAP machine that you would need for sleeping overnight. This specific pack at 3,000 watt hours will actually power a CPAP machine for 40 hours. So if you need to sleep for 40 hours, you can have your CPAP machine running that long. Another real world example of usage is like your chest freezer or your refrigerator. Say it uses 500 watts. This pack will power that device for up to 5 hours, which is really important when you got stuff that's gonna spoil. If you guys have ever used a different generator, like a gas powered generator, you quickly realize how loud it is. The thing with this Jackery pack is that it almost makes no noise at all. When it is charging, the sound is about 30 dB, which is really, really quiet. And if you're anything like me and you require really quiet to sleep, this thing is the ticket for you. It virtually produces no noise at all. Now that we've gone over some of the features, let's take this thing on the road and see what other things we gotta do on our list that the Jackery pack will help us accomplish. You ready to go, Frankie?
Hey, you wanna go?
Let's go on a road trip. Come on, Frankie, let's go, get in the truck. Come on. Right on cue, Frankie. Well, before we even get started, I need a little bit of help from the Jackery Explorer 3000. I need to air up my tires, and what better way to air up your tires than with an electric compressor? I've got it in the back. It basically travels around in my service vehicle, and it allows me to run all my pneumatic tools. And as you guys know, when you start up a compressor, there's a lot of draw. So we're gonna start that thing up, we're gonna air up our tires, and then we'll be set to go.
We're running at 900 watts with that compressor running.
Well, before we even get started on our journey, it looks like we got to deal with this guy. This tree has come down, and if you're anything like me and really don't like smell like two-stroke chainsaw gas, it's another thing to use an electric chainsaw, but it's those cordless ones are really expensive. The corded ones are relatively inexpensive, so why not use your battery to power a corded chainsaw in the forest? Let me get that guy out of the way. because it's been annoying me for a little bit now. So let's cut that thing up, see how she does.
What do you think, Frank, you ready to go again? Yeah, we're not going far. We just got to back up to that tree. Hey, you gonna come with me?
All right, now that we've got that pretty much cleaned up and it's not going to hit us, we're going to do another project, which is fill the hot tub. And that's something that you don't really think about until you need it, is, you know, your sump pump in the basement that in the event of a power failure and it's raining, because that's usually when the power failures occur, you kind of need a battery backup. This thing will power a sump pump easily for a really long time.
So that sump pump could run for 6.5 hours at 78% battery, which is pretty incredible.
All right, the next little job I gotta do with my Jackery pack is I gotta weld this thing together, and it's hard to, you know, weld stuff. So, well, we're gonna try. We're gonna try welding it with the Jackery. So plug it in, turn it on. This is something you really can't do with most packs because they just don't have enough power. So as you guys can see, that handled it pretty much flawlessly. We got that all welded up. That's the handle for one of my grain bin jacks. I actually got to steal a piece of rebar from it. But now I've got it repaired, so I can put that back with my grain bin jacks. But yeah, remote welding. That's another thing this Jackery guy can do easily. I always find that you never have enough batteries, especially with your cordless tool. So I have 6 of them charging simultaneously on the Jackery pack, and it seems to be doing no problem. It's just chicken away, ticking away, charging those batteries up. So when I want to use my cordless tools, I can. I also happen to have a battery charger / car booster on board if I need to boost the Jeep, or for that matter, if I need to charge my hydraulic cylinder that dumps my dump trailer. I plug this guy in to the Jackery pack, and then I can actually charge that, or I can boost the vehicle in case I forget the lights on or if I leave the doors open too long. That gets me out of a jam in a hurry.
If you guys are in the market to purchase a solar generator, you guys should check out the Jackery Explorer 3000 Pro. The link will be in the description below. I highly recommend them. Check them out today. Thanks for hanging out with me today. If you guys are in the market to get yourself your very own solar generator, be sure to check out Jackery Explorer 3000 Pro. It is one of the best solar generators on the market. It has performed flawlessly. Anything I can or have thrown at it, it has performed flawlessly. It runs it exceptionally well. This is the pack to get. And did I mention, hurricane season's just around the corner, and it's better to be looking at it than looking for it. It's better to be prepared.